Hallelujah! Everyone, thanks very much for tuning in to a little podcast and a catch-up session with WPG's very own Ksenia Komnenovic. Thank you so much for joining us, Ksenia.
Thank you so much for having me, Tim. It's so exciting to be back with the group, at least virtually.
Yeah, I know things have changed since you were with us. I think April 2019, roughly, was that right?
Yep.
So probably one of the last times everyone got the chance to sort of travel and perform, really, before everything sort of massively changed. So yeah, what's been happening in your world? Like, what's the updates?
Well, as you know, at the time when we were touring, I spoke to you about my upcoming my upcoming job audition, and you and Jason were both witches, and you said that I was going to win this job, and I did. So I'm calling in from Texas, where I teach at Texas A&M University in Corpus Christi, which is lovely. It's my third year now, and definitely teaching during COVID was fun and informative, and not fun actually at all, but we learned a lot and we were okay. So that's yeah, the important thing. But yeah, doing a lot of stuff, you know. I'm running my own chamber ensembles. I'm going on a little fall tour now myself to Russia and Poland. I've learned a lot from the best. So I'm doing that now for myself. I'm producing my first album, which is exciting. I arranged the Rite of Spring for percussion or for marimba and piano. And I'm joined by a lovely pianist on it, Liana Heron. So that's going to come out soon. I started writing a book, like a bunch of stuff is going on, but yeah, that's a summary.
Yeah, great. I was actually reading your biography before we just came on, and it said that I didn't actually know this, that you're a composer as well.
Yeah. I got my bachelor's degree in composition.
Oh, there you go. See, I never knew that all this time. So what, do you still write much or not really?
I do, not as much. I definitely took a little bit of a break from composition. I wasn't that interested. Percussion was definitely my first love, but I've gone back into it. I've done some like video game scoring and movie scoring, and then I recently did a little ballet miniature for the reopening of a museum of a Nobel Prize winner in Bosnia. And that was super fun. And then I got a commission, my first commission to write a band piece. So I'll now be writing a wind band piece for next year, which is really
Cool.
Yeah.
That's quite a large scale thing. So in your course, did you learn about, so presumably you learned about composition for all instruments or have a general idea? Yeah.
I mean, I studied it for 5 years, went through a very rigorous process. So yeah.
So you know the pitfalls, not to annoy anyone.
Yeah, I try to be a good person.
Yeah, great. Okay, well, I suppose the first question I wanted to ask you, really, sort of touring a lot myself, and you know, you always find students, actually you sort of touched on this already, but you always find students sort of wanting to go into like these teaching jobs. And one thing sort of that struck me when we met you as sort of principal of WPG was your... you know, you're a coherent manner, you have clearly a real passion for music, but you're a real role model as well for the other artists. And I was just wondering what your thoughts on in terms of people that want to go into teaching and a strategy for applying for these jobs, because it's such a minefield and so many people looking to get into those positions. So you picked my brains a few months back, so this is my turn now. So
yeah, nice, now you get to pay back. Yeah, it was lovely to have you on the podcast. Well, you know what, it's a very difficult thing, and there are no rules, and I hate it when people respond, you know, start the response that way, then you're like, why am I even listening to this? But I guess the only thing that I can say is do as much as you can. I don't necessarily know how I won this particular job. I just remember having a list of attempts and failures on my wall, because I lived in Hong Kong back that year when I went on tour with you, and I was applying for college teaching jobs. And I had a list of, I think, almost 30 schools that I applied to teach at. And I did not get through the Skype at the time, Skype round, because Zoom wasn't a thing, the interview round at any of them except for this one. And then I won it. This was my first interview ever, and I won it. And I didn't expect that. Usually people say, you know, it takes a while, you need to find your footing, and interviews can be really strange, but this was just something clicked. And point is, you are unique. Play to your strengths, figure out everything else that you might see is a trend that people need wherever you want to go and work. And then, you know, just keep going at it. You need to keep creating opportunities for yourself. Things like WPG was a wonderful thing for me to do, to practice teaching, to tour, to meet as many people, to gain confidence, to expand my network. And I think ultimately it was also important for my job audition, because they saw me as someone who just stepped in from international tour. I wasn't just sitting somewhere and coming in to audition. So doing as many things as you can to find opportunities and create opportunities for yourself is number one thing. And then, of course, patience, mountains of patience, because now is very different from 20 or 50 years ago, even when you could get a job straight out of school. Here you have to sort of get used to the fact that you will struggle emotionally and financially for at least a bit of time after graduating, unless you are really exceptional or exceptionally lucky.
Yeah, no, I completely agree with that. I think that, I mean, the first thing is, as you say, like so many applications and then you didn't even meet someone. So, you know, a piece of paper, that's what you are until the next step. So it's trying to, I suppose, make yourself, like with any job, make yourself sort of stand out in a way that is interesting to the person that's going to employ you. So maybe a little bit of research is beneficial too. On the other part.
That's a must. I did all of that, of course, for every job. It's really important that you know what you're applying for, because they expect you to do that, but that's also it's valid. They are auditioning for you as well, and you want to know what you're getting yourself into. Don't just be like, oh, someone take me, please. I mean, yeah. Know what you're going for.
Yeah. I think the thing about sort of interviews as well, which I've got a little bit more confident on over the, as I've got older, is to sort of spark conversations, or almost ask questions back as a conversation rather than it being one-sided.
Absolutely.
Yeah, this having the confidence to do that, isn't it? Especially when, like, I was younger, I would have done that. But I think now I'm probably a little bit more wiser to the fact that, you know, people want to see a conversation rather than just question, answer, you know. So,
They want to hire a colleague. I mean, they want to hire someone who can have a productive conversation. And also, I think that's what people who have recently graduated, they might have a hard time with overcoming that idea that there was a hierarchy before. Perhaps maybe they had it with their teachers, I don't know. But, you know, where you're just supposed to be answering and not asking too many questions. And then seeing yourself as equal to someone who might be sitting in your committee and is 30, 40 years your senior, and you wouldn't normally call them Dr. something, something, but now they're supposed to be a buddy. So there's things to overcome there, but there's definitely plenty of resources online. And I think WPG helped me a lot to figure all that stuff out before my audition.
Yeah, and sort of, I guess, a little bit of a shameless plug, but you are on the WPG channel. So talking about like the 2019 tour, where I believe, if my memory serves me right, we went to Spain and Portugal.
Yes.
Lovely. So just wondered if you could talk a little bit about sort of the project and maybe how it helped shape you as a musician, or maybe as a person a little bit.
Yeah. You know, I went into that actually thinking, because I was working in Hong Kong and I was working at a middle school and a high school. It wasn't a percussion-centric job. And I remember thinking I miss chamber music so, so, so much. And I don't know if I'm ever going to win a college teaching job or be in the sort of center of percussion anymore. I am going to then invest in going to these things, even if it means once a year I get to hang out with some international crew and make music. I'm going to be super happy. Some people have skiing and they want to do that once per year. I'm going to do this. This is going to be my vacation. And I remember being really excited, and then all of my ideas of how lovely the people would be came true. I mean, starting from you and Jason, how you were so generous to us and helpful and open and honest, especially about that transition into, hey, this is what real life is. And then everybody in that group just being lovely, from Antoine to Will to Christina, Beavis and Eugene, my Hong Kong buddies, like Bryce, who's now my neighbor, Jonas, Alyssa, Chase, like Neshka and Alex, and then the whole thing, Chen Yi, Emily, like that whole crew was so special. And what I think shaped me a lot was the fact that you curated the environment so well. And I saw that you did that again for this year. The crew that you have now are some folks who I've met previously in competitions who are absolutely lovely. And I think not just the experience of traveling was amazing, but just being around these people who are all so different and all have different ideas of what they want to do, but yet we were all such great friends and just had to make music really quickly together. I think that was spectacular. And then the other thing was, you know, even though I'd say I've performed quite a bit beforehand, I've never had this experience of not being able to be in control of everything, because I'm a control freak. And so the thing was, I mean, in case you didn't pick up on it, but when we were on a cruise, and then we get off and run to a conservatory to perform. There was no way to be there early, to be there earlier to set up to make sure everything is like really, 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 really right. No, you have this amount of time, and there's a lot of people who need to get set up, and you just need to get going. And I think that, my apologies, my email is
You're okay. That's really fine. Early.
You need to figure this stuff really quickly, and to see how our levels of nervousness and excitedness change, and how different audiences react to the same repertoire being played, you know, in different countries. Mm-hmm. Not a lot of people get to experience that. We usually practice, we play one recital, maybe one extra, you know, time you run something for someone, and that's it, you drop it. Here, there's the evolution of our chamber music playing, of that, how the audience reacts to that music, of how we feel when we go on stage. I mean, the first time I played Caleb Pickering's Powder Keg, failed to mention him, he's a lovely person too. I mean, that piece made me stress out a bit, but then it was, in the end, it was just like, oh, this is awesome. These guys are like my rock band. So
yeah,
I mean, a million things were really, really beneficial from like just jumping into the cold water of every situation being different and being flexible to figure out how to talk to these people, how to interact with an audience, to just being bunched up with a lot of different people and figuring out to make music. And ultimately, I mean, there was so much fun too. It was just such a great, it really wasn't like networking. It wasn't that cold and sterile. It was really like a friendship in the making.
Yeah. It's quite interesting sort of social experiment sometimes, just seeing how people, because I obviously, I don't know everyone before they come, but I've spoken to them and I get a feel for the personalities of each person. And I like thinking like, oh, I wonder if they'll get on with this person or whatnot, and just see what actually happens. It's really interesting. But
I mean, it's not just get on. Alex and Neshka, you match me.
That is true. We've got our first marriage. So, I mean, if anyone's interested in getting married, sign up for WPG. That's yeah, I should have them on, really, shouldn't I? That's so true. But yeah, I think that's one of the sort of musical comments has been from pretty much everyone, is they didn't realize how little time they would have to, and little time like traveling as well. Like, you can't practice when you're traveling. It's like literally that's it. Like, relax, and you know, mentally maybe you can, but not physically. So
yeah,
I think that was quite shocking for a lot of people. Like, we get there and you know, you're running 10, it's like rabbit in the headlights sometimes. But you know, that's life sometimes. So I think, again, that's a good learning experience.
Absolutely.
And I do remember you on that tour practicing velocities, I think, for that particular audition. So
yeah, asking you sort of when we were in England and still had those, the first few days of full day of rehearsals, like, could I, when there's lunch break, just squeeze out so I go and practice a bit?
Yeah, totally, totally. Okay, great. Well, I know, Ksenia, I know you've got to get off. You've got a very busy day ahead, I'm sure. But thank you so much for joining us. I've just got a really very quick clip of Ksenia playing with Chen Yi, if that's okay.
Yes,
And we will see you soon, and I will leave it there. So thank you very much. Have a great day, Ksenia, and we'll speak soon.
Thanks so much for having me. Have a blast for the rest of this virtual tour.
Yeah, and do tell all your students and friends. Most of the sessions will be at least highlights, if not some of them will be live, so people can actually join in some of the sort of group of sessions. John Wooten's and Mendy Singh is completely open, so you can get your students to join in and play along with the pad.
Awesome. Cool. Awesome. Cool.
Definitely. All right. I'll see you soon.
See you soon.
Bye. Take care.
You too.